Hello, this is still the 14th of July. A little bit more about RT-PCR. This time I'll tell you who are first. When do we repeat RT-PCR? Suppose the patient's RT-PCR is negative on day 3 of symptoms. Many people would like to repeat the RT-PCR to be, you know, kind of sure that we have to diagnose it through RT-PCR. My suggestion is do not repeat RT-PCR. Once negative, usually it stays negative because the viral load initially was not good enough to show the RT-PCR positivity. So but many people will still repeat it, and that happens in hospitalized patients also. If they find it negative first, they will keep on repeating. Do you repeat an RT-PCR which was positive first to demonstrate that it is now negative? Again, I would say usually not. After 10 days of onset of illness, we usually declare a patient non-infective even if the RT-PCR is positive. This is because the RT-PCR can be positive because of viral fragments that are not infective anymore. You can call them inactive or dead remnants of the virus. So RT-PCR to repeat for discharge criteria had been done before. They used to say if the load is less based on the cycle threshold value above 33, for example, then they could discharge the patient. But all those criteria are now not. One, logistics, because you're spending more money, and second, very low likelihood of patient being infective after 10 days of onset of symptoms. So this is about repetition of RT-PCR. The second thing that I want to talk to you about is what is this cycle threshold value. We have seen that it is now being reported frequently on the reports of labs. What is cycle threshold value? As we said, after the reverse transcriptase enzyme converts the RNA to DNA, the DNA is put into a polymerase chain reaction, and that amplifies or multiplies the DNA till it becomes identifiable. If the DNA becomes identifiable after a very few cycles, that means the initial DNA load was high. That means the initial viral load was high. If it takes many more cycles to amplify the DNA, it means the initial load was low. So amplification in how many cycles is called cycle threshold, CT value. It is said that usually it takes 17 cycles at least to detect the virus. Therefore, the CT value will become 17 if the viral load is high. If the viral load is above 30, if the cycle threshold is above 30, that means the viral load is low. So they classify as 17 to 23 significant viral load, 24 to 30 moderate viral load, and more than 30 very low viral load. That is the approximate classification of the CT value. So CT value, the lower it is, the worse it is the conclusion. So that's all about the CT value. Lastly, about some practical aspects of the RT-PCR. Cost as of today, 2,800. If they do a home visit, they might charge a couple of hundred extra. Usually it's a drive-through test at a center where the lab, just right next to the road, there is usually a kiosk from where technician will come and collect your swab. So that is the usual method of collecting the swab. So you can go in a car. If you're sending a patient, then I would say make sure that you're not exposing a driver to the patient. So if the patient is mildly symptomatic, they can drive themselves, or they can go in a rickshaw with a car following, and you protect the rickshaw driver by wearing a good mask, N95 mask. Since an open air rickshaw, the chances of transmission to the driver become very less. Therefore, do not take an Uber when you go for a drive-through test. That's all, and thank you.